watch anything, tries to rationalize. Cause somehow I knew that there was more than just chemistry. I mean, I know you were kind of into me, but I figured it's too good to be true. I said, pinch me, where's the catch this time? Can't find a single cloud in the sky. Help me before I get used to this guy. They say that good things take time, but really great things happen in the blink of an eye. You have the chance.
The 8th grade night will be held on March 15th from 6 to 7 p.m.
I'm going to the 8th grade night because I want to take a tour of it, and it's going to be a good experience.
It's important to go to 8th grade night because it gives you a chance to familiarize yourself with the building. You also get to know some of the teachers and coaches that you're going to have when you get over to the high school. And you get to hear about different clubs and activities because they have some offerings that we don't have here at the middle school.
I'm scared I'll get lost and picked on by the older kids at the high school.
So there's a lot of things that go on at the high school that we don't have the opportunity to offer here at the middle school. It's just a chance to learn about all that before you start school there next fall. So it's a great chance to go meet new people that you're going to be around on a regular basis for the next 4 years.
I'm Katie Henson, and I will be attending the 8th grade night, so you should too.
We went around SMS asking students if a mitt was a candy or a food.
Obviously, it's a food.
It's a candy.
It's a food.
It's a candy.
I think a mint is a candy because you don't chew it.
It's a food.
I think a mint is a gross candy.
Mint is a candy.
It's a candy.
Because it comes in a wrapper.
Neither.
It's candy because it's in the candy section.
I think a mint is a candy because it doesn't really fill you up, but it still tastes good.
It's a candy because it tastes like a candy.
A mint is a candy because it's in the candy aisle.
I think it's a candy.
You know what?
What?
A mint is actually a candy or a food.
And Show Choir are performing their Broadway Nights concert on March 14th.
My name's Michaela and I'm in mixed chorus. We are doing Good Morning Baltimore, Good Night My Someone, Guys and Dolls, and For Good. And my favorite is Good Morning Baltimore.
Students who got solos were Sierra, Jocelyn, Christian, Gavin, Kaylin, Delaney, Laura, Faith, Olivia, Caroline and Riley.
I'm looking forward to this choir concert because I think it's going to be really good and the crowd is going to be great and our songs are looking good.
Type of songs, and I really like Mamma Mia because I have a solo dance.
Since the day we parted, why did I ever let you go? Mamma Mia, now I really know.
I'm Jocelyn Cunningham, and
the choir concert's gonna be lit.
We need to go to work on our skits.
Yeah. It's Monday. We're fine.
Okay, I think we could do karaoke, but with the teachers.
We did that like 2 weeks ago. It's too soon.
Okay, but that was 2 weeks ago. It's 2 weeks later now. We can do it again.
Okay, how about riddles?
Oh my god,
we always do riddles.
They're
I don't know what we could do if we can't come up with something.
Let's just do an obstacle course and be done with it.
Two.
Let's just do it tomorrow, though.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go.
Amber Buford, a sixth grader at SMS, does Taekwondo at Monroe's ATA Academy in St. Joe.
Whenever I get home from school, I leave to go to Taekwondo, and we do warm-ups, and we just run back and forth across the court, and then we just practice forms and weapons. We went shopping one day, and we signed up for three weeks of martial arts, and the first day we went, we liked it, and so our parents signed us up. We learned, like, if you were to get... If someone wants to try to take you, we learn self-defense so you can get away, and we learn forms to go to tournaments and win medals. Ember, like, showed me a move, like, if someone, like, grabbed your wrist or something, like, you, like, pull in and, like, punch them in the gut or something like that, and I thought it was super cool because I've never really seen anything like it.
I'm Brett Lynch, reporting for SWR, and I'm signing off.
On Wednesday, March 1st, Mr. Melvin started his girls' golf training in the middle school gym once or twice a week.
So we're holding indoor after-school golf practices because over the winter, not everyone is able to play golf. It's too cold outside, windy, snowy, whatever. So I just want to make sure we keep crisp over the off-season and that we are able to take swings. And then we work on some things like chipping, maybe hitting a few long irons, stuff like that, that we don't always get to work on over the course of the season. We have a really good chance to be good next year, and I want to make sure we take every advantage we have to capitalize on that.
The practice will be held in the middle school gym at 3:30 to 4:30. Anybody in track can also join because Mr. Melvin is working around the track schedule.
I'm Elena Leffler, and I'm signing off.
Miss Whittington's community will be participating in the Act to Stamp Out Hunger for the Second Harvest Food Bank.
So last year, my community and a couple other communities stuffed bags for the Second Harvest Stamp Out Hunger campaign, and that is their biggest food drive of the year.
What Savannah Middle School has to do to help out is to fill bags with sign-up forms for families who are in need of food. These bags are also for families who are not in need and can fill the bags with canned goods and other non-perishable foods to help out. There are also 10 other teachers who have agreed to help out Miss Whittington's community. Miss Snyder, Miss Roster, Miss Jackson, Miss Carlisle, Miss Baldwin, Miss Lawrence, Miss Hengler, Miss McFadden, Mr. Williams, and Miss Whittington.
Our community is going to help out with the Second Harvester Food Bank food drive because it's an opportunity for us to serve, and it's a great cause where they help people with that can't afford to buy their own food and that are hungry. So we're going to do it.
These community teachers, community members, will be working on filling these bags during downtime and community.
Please help fill these bags if you get the chance. And I'm Ben Rogers, reporting for SWR News.
Savannah Middle School 8th graders wanting to try out for high school cheerleading, get ready. Tryouts are starting next week from March 13th to March 16th. There will be interviews with teachers on March 16th,
and the actual tryouts will be on March 17th.
I'm excited for high school cheer because middle school cheer was really fun, so I'm looking forward to it.
I'm excited for high school cheer because I did it last year and competition's fun.
There was a parent meeting this past March 9th to talk to parents about what the year entails and costs.
Reporting for SWR, I'm Bryson Rose, signing off.
We went around Savannah Middle School and got students to see if they could do the alphabet under 4 seconds.
ABCDFGHHJKLMNOPQRSTUVWXYZ.
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 ABCDEFGHIJKLMNOPQRSTUVWXYZ.
ABCDEFGHIJKLMNOPQRSTUVWXYZ.
ZUXBBTSRQPONNLKJHFCBA.
Great job, SMS!
On St. Patrick's Day, Student Council will be holding the annual Teacher Appreciation Breakfast.
The 8th graders will be showing up at 5 o'clock and cooking the breakfast. They will be cooking shamrock pancakes, monkey bread, Stucco pizza, biscuits and gravy, rainbow watermelon, mini pizza biscuits, fruit juices, and coffee.
I'm excited for the Teachers Appreciation Breakfast because as 8th graders, we get to cook all of the food this year, and I'm excited to give back to the teachers.
The 7th graders will be showing up at 7 o'clock and serving the breakfast.
I'm excited for the Teachers Appreciation Breakfast because I want to serve the teachers.
The 6th graders will be showing up at 6 o'clock and cleaning.
I'm excited for the Teachers Appreciation Breakfast. I'm not totally excited about cleaning up, but I know in the future that I can do other stuff besides cleaning after.
The breakfast will officially start at 7:15 on St. Patrick's Day. Reporting for SWR News, I'm Hadlin Snipes, signing off.
Represented well for SMS.
and his wife had their baby at 2:31 p.m. last Friday. She was 20.5 inches long, 6 pounds and 13 and a half ounces.
Mr. Phillips had a baby girl, and they named her Luna, which is actually named after a moth. Had her a few days ago. Mr. Phillips is the other science teacher that I work with, and he's definitely proud to have a baby girl at home.
It's different having Mr. Phillips in the classroom because he would always have nicknames for people, and he would always have different jokes and stuff about people and stuff.
Mr. Phillips having his baby is kind of bittersweet for me. I mean, I'm really happy that everything was safe and as a cute little kid, but now I'm not the center of his attention anymore, so that's kind of sad.
I'm Sage Eaton, and I think Luna's really cute.
So, Zach has been acting weird lately, hasn't he?
Yeah, about all this Illuminati stuff going around.
I think there's something super suspicious going on around here. I think the Illuminati is connected to Savannah Middle School.
Wow, not surprised. He's always talking about this Illuminati stuff.
Yeah. Are you guys serious? You don't actually believe this stuff? I have a ton of evidence to prove this stuff. Come with me. I'll show you that this stuff is actually real.
A little suspicious, eh?
Savannah Savages. There is 1, 2, 3 S's in Savannah Savages. Three S's? You mean three sides? Is there something you're not telling us? Like this triangle with an I right in the middle of it?
Lately, Zach's been going crazy about that Illuminati stuff.
Yeah, art class. Yeah, it's art class, all right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, something's a little suspicious.
Yeah, this must be what they're making in art class.
Zach, you're going crazy. Why don't we go to Mr. Howard and talk about this?
Okay, fine, whatever you say.
Guys, the Illuminati has nothing to do with Savannah Middle School.
Fine.
I guess so. I guess so. See, Zach, we told you so.
Fine, you guys were right.
They don't suspect anything.